We're studying individuals who have cerebral palsy, which is an individual had like an early brain injury, and it affects their movement that they have and their mobility within the community. Unfortunately, within this patient population, the therapeutic strategies that we use to improve mobility are not always optimal. In fact, some of the individuals will have really large gains after physical therapy, while others will be like, something's just not quite right, and their ability to interact within our community is just not optimized. And what we're trying to do is figure out what neurophysiologically is governing these changes that we see. So we're trying to use some high-tech instrumentation like brain imaging to look at like what changes in the brain after you learn to walk, after you undergo physical therapy, what changes within the spinal cord. We're trying to use those as kind of like biomarkers to predict the extent of the clinical outcomes. We have these instruments that are called magneto encephalography, which is a kind of a difficult word to say, but it's referred often to as MEG. And what it does is it evaluates the natural activity that comes to when your brain is working. And so what we do is we have the individuals perform like some leg movement tasks or feeling sensations, and we look at how the brain processes that information. We also use MRI. And so what we're interested in is how the brain structure changes, or the structure of the spinal cord changes in a beneficial way. Beyond that, we also use just a bunch of clinical measures to look at how the just general performance and your motor actions and your ability to walk essentially are augmented through these therapeutic protocols. What we hope is that we identify what is changed neurophysiologically within the brain and how it's different for those who respond or do not respond. We can parse out sensory processing and how you actually execute your leg motor actions. So if we identify that like a patient has problems with sensory processing, we can then derive a therapeutic program that focuses on sensations and awareness of your body. Or if you have problems in generating your motor actions, maybe it's how you plan your motor actions or execute it. If it's planning, well then the therapeutic protocol can focus on planning and thinking about how you move. So essentially, this is a springboard for identifying the key therapeutic ingredients that we should use to promote beneficial changes in all children that have cerebral palsy.